Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sujit this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about execute process task. So let's start with execute process task. So what execute process task does? So it is used to run an application or batch files. So we can use to open any standard application like Microsoft Excel or Microsoft SQL Server, run business applications or batch files. It can be also used to compress or expand any files. So here our first case study, we just want to open any notepad file, and then in our second case study, I would like to copy any folder from any specific location to other location. So this is our text file, and I would like to open this file once our package will be executed. So go to our SSDT, and here let me create one more package and then call this package as execute process task. Here I would like to drag and drop execute process task, then double click on this execute process task. Go to on process. Inside this process we can see we have executable. Here we need to specify what we want to do. So we want to open notepad, so we need to specify notepad.exe file. Then inside this argument we need to specify our file path. So this is our folder, and what is our file? And our file is this text file, so we can copy and paste it here. That is fine. In working directory we can specify our directory. So this is our directory, that is fine. Now in our Windows style we can see it has option for normal, maximize, minimize and hidden. So I am happy with normal. Now click on OK. So once our package will be executed, then that note file should be opened. So click on start. So here as we can see, text file .txt has been opened, and this package will be running until this file will not be closed. So let me close this file. So our package has been executed successfully. Now stop this package and let me disable this execute process task. And so let me drag and drop one more execute process task. So here what our plan? So here we have a source folder. So in this source folder we are having files and subfolder. So we want to copy all these files with the subfolder, and we want to paste in destination, and here we don't have any data. So how we can do this? Go to on SSDT, double click on this execute process task, go to on processes. Here we need to specify executable, that would be xcompy.exe. Then we need to specify our source path, so that is our F, then sources. So this is our F directory. Then we have sources folder. So this is our source. What we want to copy? We want to copy all the files. Then where we want to copy? We want to copy inside the destination folder. So this is our destination folder. And then we need to specify slash with S. So it will copy all the files with the subdirectory. If we are not going to specify slash with S, then it will not copy the subdirectories. Now click on OK. So as we can see, initially we don't have any file in this destination folder. So let me execute the package. So package executed successfully, and here our data have been copied. Now stop this package. In our next case study, here we can zip the file and we can also unzip the file. So how we can do the zip? Go to inside this source folder, and we want to zip txt file. So go to on SSDT, and let me disable this execute process task and drag and drop one more. So this is for the zip, that is fine. Double click on this execute process task, go to on processes. Inside this executable we need to specify, so as I am using 7jet, so this is our executable file. In the argument First we need to specify A because we wanna zip. After that we need to specify minus T 7 Z. After that we want to specify our path. I wanna zip the file inside the source folder. So this is our source folder, and then we need to specify zip file. So that is our text file, text.zip. After that we need to specify our path where we will get the file. So we will get the file from this source, then text file dot txt. Then in working directory we need to specify f with source. So it is showing error 7z.exe not available. So we need to specify our full path. So it is available inside the C, then program files, then 7 minus zip. So this is our full path. Click on OK. Looks good. Now execute our package. So package executed successfully. So stop this package and go to on the folder. So here as you can see we are getting the zip file. So this is for the zip. So how we can do the unzip this text file. So go to on SSDT and let me disable this execute process task as well and drag and drop one more. And this is for the unzip. So this is unzip. Now double click on this. Go to on process. Here we need to specify full path, that is our program file. Then 7z.execute. In argument we need to specify E for the unzip. Then we need to specify folder path with the file name. So this is our zipped file. So let me copy this and paste it here. So inside the working directory I just wanna use source. Now click on OK. Then go to in the folder and here I would like to delete the file. So once our package will be executed, then our file will be unzipped. Now click on start. So package executed successfully. Stop this package and go to on the folder. And here we can see we are getting the file. So I hope you have understand how we can use the execute process task. So by using execute process task we can copy the folder and paste in other location, and we can also zip and unzip the file according to our requirement, and we can also open the standard applications. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.